Hi guys, and welcome back to an episode of Memories of Mars. So I'm here at the PvP area right next to it, and my plan for today is to actually show you how I designed and built my freaking Deuterium base, because I got raided like 2 to 3 times there. There are some players in this, on this server that actually have like a ton of explosive chargers, and you need a lot of them. One explosive charge do like 5,000 and plus, like 5,000 and something, 5,500 or something like that damage. So in order to breach in one of these bases, it's you need like 50 or even more explosive charges, which is a lot. Okay, but they still managed to go inside it, so I decided to add another level, the one with the windows and the shooting ports up there, the third floor. Actually it's not, it's the fifth floor. So what I how I did it, I literally made it with only fortified gates. Why I did that? Because a fortified gate has 60,000 health, a wall has only 45. So I did like 4 floors, 2-1 on top of each other of these gates, the fortified gate, and inside I made it, let me turn on the headlight, maybe you'll see better, because it's still dark. Everything in this base is fortified. There are no other type of walls inside. My advice is that you actually have to do like layer over layer over layer over layer. Why? Because you need to put as many access administration terminals as possible. A lot of them. I have like 25 or even more, I don't even know exactly how many of them I have. Right now I have no building parts left, so my plan is to upgrade this to level 6. I already have like 36,000 flops. I still need like 14,000, so I can do it for 1,000 pieces, because I want to go crazy on this base. I will expand it and fortify it even more than that. So I'm gonna start from inside. This is my deuterium place. I have 4 of them, and I actually made a room for each one. Remember, everything, wall in this base is fortified, and I also used wall armors, but I didn't have enough aluminium, and I also don't have enough building parts left to put wall armor on all walls, because last time when they come to the roof. So my fortified gates actually worked, and they have vanguard jump suits. I guess they have this where is it? This jetpack thing, and they can jump easily, you know. I don't know how many floors they can jump, hopefully 5. I don't know, I never had a jetpack, and by the time I get it I will gonna find out how high you can jump actually up on top, because I'm gonna go up until they will not be able to jump on the roof, you know. And another thing that you might wish to do is to do like at least 2 to 3 layers around this. I have like 2 right now with the gates, but I'm planning to do another one. So as you can see, every single, I have 4 deuterium extractors. Each one of them is on his own room, so you can do that if you want to, you know. Why? Because I made it even harder. If they manage to breach in one room, then they'll have to use even more explosive to go into the other one. So Okay, so that's... This is the first floor, actually. And all around the base, if you can see, I put doors, I put administration terminals. The walls have all of them have armor on them, you know? Extra armor. It's like 1,500, but it will force them to use one bomb for this 1,500 HP wall armor, you know. And this is how I did it. This is the first floor. Okay, now we are going to the upper floor, you know. Okay, more as many as possible of those access terminals. And this is the floor, the upper floor. They managed to breach to this corner, destroy one of the ceilings, and then they land on this. I also intend to put wall armor on every single one of these walls. I still don't have enough parts, and I'm gonna make like a honeycomb in here again. More walls, more doors, more, you know. I'm gonna make it like a stupid maze, so it will be even harder for them, you know. Most of the walls have armor on them, but not all of them. The upper ones don't have, so I'm gonna do that also. And I got double roof, actually, you know. Now, they managed, last time they breached, they managed to breach one of these two ceilings around here, and then they go straight into the deuterium room. That was smart, I thinking. Now I have 1, 2, and even 3 fortified roofs. You know, fortified square tile. Okay, hopefully they will not going to be successful in breaching the tree. Now they need to breach to this one, to this one, and there is another one down there. You know, every single freaking wall has a this wall armor. I'm gonna put even more of them, you know. This place up here, it's useless, but it can be used to shoot down drones. That's why I designed it with only shooting ports. All of them are fortified. Everything is fortified in this base. Okay, so this is my actual base. This is a large room that is completely empty and completely useless. Now let's go down again. This is it. Hopefully this actually will help you in make your own base. Hopefully like I did it. And trust me, there is no base that cannot be raided. All the bases in this on these PvP games can be raided. I used to play Ark, and no matter how many turrets and no matter what you will have done, your base, it will be raided no matter what, you know, because there are bigger clans that play the game with a lot of members, and they have the power and the time to actually gather all the necessary resources in order to make enough bombs and stuff like that so they can raid you, you know. This poor guy here is getting raided like daily, but he literally have nothing inside. Can I farm through his floor? Yes, I can. The rocks are growing through its floor. This should not happening. I mean, yeah. He placed like one deuterium, but he never actually managed to farm some deuterium because he's getting raided like daily. So that, yeah, that's my base. This is the one that I hopefully survive long enough. as I said, I'm gonna go even crazier than that. I'm gonna go, like, I don't know, one wall around again. I'm gonna do even more that. I'm gonna wall it again with one row of foundations and walls and stuff like that. Because, yeah. Because why not, you know? We just have to be sure that we're not gonna get raided again. So you can find magnesium in this area too. If you look around, there is quite a lot of it. Not a small amount, but it requires to move around through a dangerous place like this one. You can always be sniped. And the easiest part to actually scout the entire PvP area is from that tower using binoculars or a 8x scope, you know. So they usually stay there and up there, and they scout around and kill all the players by sniping them from that tower. Which is okay, I don't have anything against them. But yeah, I don't know. The game is getting, I think, lost the support. I'm not sure if this game will actually be continued by the developers. I read a lot of stuff about it on the internet, and it seems that the last update was in May this year, and since then we received no further updates, and I guess the game is actually dead. Is that because the PvP part, the only thing that keeps the players playing it, it's bad. I mean, there are only safe areas and a very small part of the game it's actually PvP, and which means that the players reach the end game and build the bases like mine, which is literally almost impossible and unprofitable to breach in, because you will not gonna get any loot out of it. And yeah, I don't know what to say about it, but my opinion, this game, it's quite hard to balance it. I remember when this game was launched like 2 years ago, I played it straight away from day one, and the game was full PvP on all map, you know. You build a base and the second day you don't have that base, because if you play alone, you're gonna get freaking raided. So they used to restart the servers like every 3 months and or so, but it was an issue with the PvP. No one else is playing the game. This have like a knife with two cuts, because the solo players like me will never be able to play a full PvP game like Ark or like this one if all the map was PvP. Being solo, it's hard to gather enough resources to defend yourself, and you cannot fight against bigger clans, bigger tribes, bigger alliances, you know. Where there are like 4 to 5 to even more players in one alliance, and they will literally wipe out the entire server, which is bad. So I played for like 2 weeks and they completely raided me like 2 to 3 times, and I give up. I never played that game for like 2 years. So this game actually, so also was bad. It's bad. It's quite tricky to make games like this ones, you know. In my opinion, the only way in which you can survive with a PvP, I don't know, maybe they should try, maybe, I don't know. The only way I see it to, with a game like this one, with a survival crafting and on an open map like this one is to actually don't allow any alliances, tribes or anything like that. Simply do not allow that. Let the player only single player, because you can't even the balance between the players. Most of the players are playing solo, and there are players that are playing huge, large tribes, alliances, or clans, or so on, and they will always dominate the servers. You know, and this is available actually for every single PvP game, crafting survival PvP game that it's out there. There is basically impossible for you to survive in a game like this, you know. I don't know how to actually balance this game to make it more fun, but the game lost the people lost the interest in the game because they reached the end of the game and they literally have nothing else to do. They literally have nothing else to do. Okay guys, so I think that's it for today. Hopefully you do enjoy it, my Deuterium tour. And right now I'm trying to do this circling the vegans. It's not the last one. I think I still got like two protocols left. Is this one and that one. So I'm gonna try to do this one and then this one. I only have left to launch this. I'm literally so close to launch the memory capsule because I have 9 power cores. And I'm gonna make a video and telling you where to get them quite easily. I already made one like 1 year ago, and it's still a good video because things didn't change since then. But I'm gonna make another one, so I'm going to show you how I got like 9 power cores in about, I don't know, 1 week. But I didn't actually my objective wasn't to farm exclusively power cores. It just happened to get them while I was playing. So yeah, that's it. Thank you guys for watching. Hopefully you do enjoy it, and I'll catch you in the next one. Bye bye.